PI3K is an enzyme and a pathway that controls cell growth. It's mutated more frequently than any other pathway in cancer, in particular in women's cancers, breast, ovarian, endometrial.
Certain tumors, when they have this mutation, they'll start to grow uncontrollably. The cell that has that mutation can become a cancer cell.
Our job is to come in with drugs or molecules that will mess that up and shut the pathway off, taking it back to being normal.
We searched over the entire world and really asked, who are the people who know best what they're doing in this pathway?
To put 8 institutions together, combining people who don't typically work together in the clinic.
We're sharing early data as we get it. We set a very aggressive set of milestones. We not only accomplished our milestones, but went way beyond. Within our very early trials, we have learned how to determine that we've got a drug that works. That data is already coming out of our studies. There are a set of patients that are showing remarkable benefit in early clinical trials.
Rarely do you see responses with investigational drugs in phase 1, but with these compounds, some very dramatic responses are being seen.
Most drugs, when given as just a single drug, even if they work, they will only work for a short period of time.
More often, we're going to have to do drug combinations. The goal, though, is to figure out which patients are likely to respond to single agent therapy and who are going to require combinations, and then what are the best combinations to use.
And that is the big effort coming out of our Stand Up to Cancer project.
If we can keep people out of trials who wouldn't benefit from the drug, only include people who will benefit, the drugs will get approved more rapidly.
That means working with multiple industries, in some cases combining drugs across industry. We now have enough success in our preclinical and co-clinical models that have persuaded them to do that.
To go from a basic science discovery to actually getting 2 different companies to combine their drugs could happen in just a remarkably fast time. And in the past, that was just thought of as impossible. You would have to get drug A approved first, and that might take 5 or 6 years, and then same thing in parallel drug B. And so we'd be talking about maybe 7 years from now we could do the combination. We're changing the time period here of what can be done dramatically.
I've never heard of this before, and it wouldn't happen without the power of this group and the company's trust in the group. The culture change is coming within our own group, with industry, and now by starting to build a dream team of dream teams. We really have brought together a team of people who are working together, collaborating, and moving forward.